to Megapoint Studio here in the city of Torino. It's me, your usual presenter, Mr. Solomon Aboyomare. With me, I have Mr. Honorable Nwosu Wisin, Chimaobi, two-time chairman of Nsunkano Local Government Development Area in Enugu. He has been the chairman two times consecutively. And here in the city is a round of visitors to look at what has been happening, because he has been living here before, traveled to Nigeria to go and contribute to nation building. So sir, today we are going to be doing just a little brief random question and answer, not actually on politics or what is happening in Nigeria, because there are so many things happening. We're not going to discuss about that. We're just going to familiarize ourselves and get to know each other better and how we can collaborate or try to develop here and home as well. So sir, from findings, we discovered that you once had a business center here in the city of Torino. Is that true?
Yeah, sure. I had a communication center. In Italian, they say official di servizio. That was located in Via San Secondo, 64, here in Torino.
Okay, that's good. For how long did you operate the?
Yeah, I actually opened the office February 2003 after some little apprentice with my brother, Chief Sam Davis Obodo.
Wow. Which means apprenticeship is still performed here in Europe, in Italy?
Yeah, sure, definitely. You must have to get acquainted with what you want to do before you don't just jump into it.
Okay. Well, this is my first time of getting that. Anyway, it's nice to know that you once served under somebody, which shows that you are the type of person that follows instruction and learn from people before moving on to start your own thing. But in general, how long have you been, how long did you live in Italy before you traveled to Nigeria?
Okay, I came to Italy here exactly precisely on November 8th, 1993.
Okay.
So and I left for Nigeria in 2008.
Okay.
Sure.
Okay, well, were you called to go to Nigeria? You traveled on your own base?
Yeah, when during the course of the business center, the activity,
yes.
I was privileged to get entangled with one of my friends that lives in Bergamo,
okay.
Jean Smith Odi.
Okay.
I joined him into taking goods to Nigeria. Mm-hmm. We are buying trucks, engines, sending it home, just diversification of business.
Okay.
So in the course of it, I was called to serve by my people.
Okay. Actually, you were originally a businessman.
Sure.
Before you were called to serve. Yeah. Meanwhile, you were living in Italy, in Torino to be precise.
Sure.
Were there no credible people who understand the local people that can lead the affair of Nsunkano?
No, it's not as if there were no credible people. In the course of my travel, because I was often and on in Nigeria, mm-hmm. I started associating myself with the politicians down home.
All right.
So, in the course of my association with them, I think they felt that I would contribute in making Enugu State go a little further.
Okay.
So I was just offered the appointment. It was like an appointment by His Excellency, the Executive Governor of Enugu State, okay. Barrister Sullivan Ihana Chachime. Mm-hmm. He found me credible. He found me as somebody that can help, having stayed overseas. Okay. And he gave me the appointment to come and serve my people,
okay.
Which I did,
okay.
To the best of my knowledge. Meritoriously.
Okay, for how long did you do that?
It was an appointment of two years of two tenure. Okay. So I served for 4 years. Yes.
Mm. And during this 4 years period, what were your achievements, your contribution to the development of the community?
Yeah, with the help of our amiable governor and the local government chairman then, the mother local government chairman then, Honorable Jigani, we were able to impact on the people. I can stand bold to tell you that during my regime, I brought some transformation following the four-point agenda of the executive governor of Enugu State,
which were
infrastructural development, security, agriculture, and the fifth one being what is it called?
Anyway, infrastructure.
Hold on. Yeah, infrastructure, security. Agriculture, security, and the human capital development.
Human capital. That is a nice one. So your people, basically, they are really proud of it because so far so good. We've been having little information in terms of insecurity in Enugu State, which means the foundation has already been laid.
Yeah, sure. Let me put one thing. During the visit of the current Inspector General of Police, when the state government gave the police 100 vehicles, the IG of police, Mohammed Abubakar, openly affirmed that Enugu State is the safest state in the country.
Wow.
As of this very moment.
That
I can assure you that
is a plus. That is a plus. I wish other states could be like Enugu, because these days Nigerians even find it difficult to visit their own country because of the situation of insecurity. But that is not the topic for today. Today we just want to familiarize ourselves and get to know how possible we can bring development both here in abroad and back then in Nigeria. But in terms of population, how large were the people, the place you live in?
And Asun Kano development area is a local government development area under Nkano East.
Okay.
And I can tell you that Nkano East has the large, it's among the largest populated area in Enugu State. From one point of Nkano East, you pass five local governments before you get to the headquarters, and all in the same area. Then, considering our population, I can tell you that Asun Kano has close to a million registered voters. Close to a million or more than a million registered voters. So they are thickly populated.
Oh, must be a really challenging job.
Yes.
But why you were there? Can you summarize briefly the challenges you face in putting such taskful affairs to the people, in terms of the people, the challenges you got from the people, and the challenges you got from the government?
Yeah, I did not actually have too many challenges, because the executive governor of the state made governance so easy. Mm-hmm. He's one of the best governors in Nigeria. Okay. We all followed his footstep. There was no way you get challenges, because we tried to buckle up his pace of development,
okay,
and has already been inculcated to the population, to the populace of the area. The little challenge I had with the people was trying to let them do the things the right way.
Oh.
Having come from overseas, it was a little bit difficult for the people to follow my pace.
Okay.
So, but actually, there was no much challenges. They followed the trend, because I told them I came to serve, to transform the area, which they actually helped. Okay. They assisted me so well. I didn't have much problem with them.
Okay, because if we look at the city of Torino, for years, the Nigerians that are living here, they are finding it very difficult to communicate within themselves in so many areas. So many things are going wrong. nobody is to be held responsible because we have no one to call as our leader here in the city of Torino. And if you look at the population of Nigeria, majority, let me see, approximately 50%, they are from the eastern part of Nigeria. Let me say Enugu. Most of my friends, they are from Enugu. When we call for sittings to discuss about affairs that will help the community, most of them want to be the leader or they will not partake from it. Did you experience such tight task challenges while you were here?
During my own time, during our time here in Italy, we had some great men from Nigeria. We had one of our leader here then, may he still rest in peace, Chido Achon. We had Francis Anyakora, Bishop. They were great men that served Nigerian community here. We had some people, Peter Iyama, he's from Edo State. We had Sylvester Weifo. We had Cletus Oko. These are great men from Nigeria. We had one of my mentors while I was here, Bengama Badege, we call him Afro Sport. He was the person in charge of Afro Sport here. They led us. We had Harry, one guy from Sabongidora. We try as much as we can to bring Nigerians together. We achieved to some extent. We had to level before the whole thing crumbled. But since I came back on this visit, I've been able to see that the new guys are trying to pick up from where we stopped. I've met the director of Megapoint, Ken Aire. I've met the U Solomon. I've been in a meeting, one or two meetings with you guys, TJ. Then the former president of Igbo Association and the current leader of Enugu State, Chief Sam Davis Obodo. I've stayed with two people, Mr. Wilson, popularly known as Abaja here in Torino. He used to be my boy in Nigeria then. I've listened with keen interest the way you people want to pilot the Nigerian community. Let me tell you people, keep it up. You're building your future politically. By this, all I wish you guys is to be very focused. Nigeria is a very complex country because we have too many tribes. It's difficult to organize them, but you people have to do your best. We've done our own during our own time, but I wish you guys well.
Thank you.
Just keep going ahead, be focused, be very sincere in what you are doing. Always consult the embassy. If there's any problem, get back to the embassy. You can write Good Luck Jonathan from here to complain if there's anything people need that is not being taken care of here in our Nigerian embassy Rome. You can write directly to the president through the National Assembly. It will get to him.
That is very interesting. One of the major important question we have today usually comes from our viewers. They have this notion that once somebody has lived in overseas for long and this person has returned home, the person can pay money to become the chairman of a local government. Is it possible? Is it true? How does it function?
No, it's a very wrong notion.
Okay.
For instance, in my own case, before I ventured into politics, I was a philanthropist, per se. I remember I'm from a very remote area Uhuona Uboka, in Asokan local government development area. I was personally sponsoring the electrification of the area with my own sweat. Then, in one of my visits, I remembered during the Igweshi tussle, they called me for a meeting on how to resolve the tussle. So in the course of it, I interacted with the chairman then. He said he has been hearing a lot about me. Who is this very Chimamodo? I said, I am my personal self. He said, okay. He called me for a meeting where they were trying to resolve on the appointment. I contributed my own little idea there to them and left them back to Italy on a business trip. So I'm going back to Nigeria. They just sent me a text message. That man is still alive, Honorable Ejikani. He was the chairman then. They were trying to make that appointment. He just said, congrats. I said, ah. I didn't see, just congrats. I called him and said, look, you sent a text to a wrong person. A text you're supposed to send to somebody came to my phone. They laughed and said, no. That you are the person that has the test. I said, what is that? I said, I've just been appointed by the governor to be the chairman of the local government development area. He's still alive. I never paid one kobo. I never paid anything.
Okay.
In Nigeria, they watch all of us.
Yes.
They know the quality each and every one of us is made up of.
Yeah.
So, it is a very wrong notion to say that people buy appointment. People don't buy appointment.
That is very good. At least most of our viewers, you've heard from a person with a personal experience. His good work has led him to the position he is now. But come to think of it, what is your actual office now? What position are you occupying in terms of
administration? Okay, after my appointment as the chairman of Sonkan Development, a local government development area, the new chairman came in, Honorable Pastor Sam Ifeanyi Chukwu Iyiogwe. He saw how I performed during my previous appointments. He said, no, he wouldn't let me go. Because I told him, I think I have to go back to overseas and take care of my investment. He said, no, that he wouldn't let me go. That he wanted me to come and serve in his own government to make sure that things is done the right way. So he gave me the senior special assistant on intergovernmental matters to the local government. So that's my present appointment.
So do you still have future political dreams in Nigeria, or you would prefer to come back to Europe and manage your stay there permanently?
No, we all can't run away from Nigeria. I was being interviewed somewhere, I told them, look, the earlier we guys oversee, come back home to see where we will help Nigeria, the better.
Okay.
I won't say I've closed the door of Italy, but I'm still in Nigeria for now to see where I will contribute my own little quota to the development of that place called Nigeria.
Okay. And finally, we are gradually going, running up this interview, this brief interview, to get to know the past and the present and ways forward and everything. Do you think, from your experience so far and with the nature of what is happening in Nigeria and what you're seeing here, that Nigeria will ever be like the Western world, like Europe? Do you think?
Let me tell you something. Nigeria might not be as old as it is. When you want to compare Nigeria and Western world, you are making a mistake. But I'll tell you, gradually, with the laudable achievements and efforts of the present government in Nigeria, we gradually arrive to that level. President Goodluck Ebele Jonathan, I wish Nigerians will allow him to go for a second tenure. with the team of economic advisors, the ministers led by Ngozi Okonjo-Iweala, and with the governors, the local government chairman, they are doing very great. I assure you, we will get there.
Okay, that is words from our senior brother, big brother, two-time chairman of Asun Kano Local Government Development Area in Enugu State. He's here in Italy to visit us, to see his friends and family whom he has made over the years. We are his brother, he's our brother, we belong together, we're still trying to make things happen, both here in Italy and in Nigeria. Thank you for staying with us today. We hope you join us for another time for a special interview with some of our brothers who have lived here and are doing well in the society. Thank you very much.
Yeah, before I go, I want to commend the Mega Point studio. When I was in Torino, we've never had this type of
initiative.
I commend you guys so much. I will deliver a message to people at home. I was highly impressed when I entered your studio. It's a first-class studio. I've had different interviews from different media organizations. I think you are above board.
Wow.
I'm happy with you guys.
Thank you.
Just quickly talk.
Okay.
Remain focused.
Okay.
Don't be shaped by the policies and laws of this country. We arrived there. Just keep on doing these things you're doing. You are delivering a message, you're propagating Nigerians to a very high level. I've never seen this anywhere in Europe. We are in Nigeria. We operate a studio as big as this. You guys, give it a hand.